Alrighty, we're doing a parting out video today. This is Zenith here. This Zenith has a broken leg, even though I have it and I could fix it. We got a broken leg on it. The badge is missing. The tuner is screwed up because this thing fell on its face. And it broke. It broke some stuff out of the tuner and broke something internally. Now it's kind of working, but you can hear things falling out of it. It doesn't come on at all, and it has a photo finish on it, which, as you can see, is coming off of one side. But the biggest problem with the set is that it's got a weak picture tube and it probably wouldn't produce much of a picture anymore. And just given the overall condition, you know, we're going to part this thing out. So I'm going to take the back off and we'll see what model it is and what chassis, and we'll take a look at the insides there. And it looks like it's a model K2735-2 with a 16K33 chassis. And way back, probably when this thing was new, it was either sold or serviced by Magazine Radio and TV. Somewhere up around, 3100 block. Somewhere around Washington, between Washington and Louisiana. Uptown. But the back's in nice shape. I'll hang on to that. Maybe we can see the broken leg laying down there. Let's get her apart and see what we shall see. And as we can see from the damage, we have some shards of plastic and the remains of... Well, this just looks like a control knob that fell off of something. This didn't come out the tuner. Well, put that over there in the parts. We've got a contractor's pencil in here. And not much else. 23 DNP4 with a 3-18 date code. And let's see. Yep, 63, yeah, so this is a 63 built set. No UHF. That all makes sense. K33. And I had tested the picture tube when I first received the set, and this disc was very, very weak. And I have tried to power it on to no avail. We'll look for the fuse in here and see if we can't find a fuse and see what we can do. Alrighty, all channel reject switch, REJ. We'll have. So we got it plugged in, and what happens is, as soon as you turn her on, it trips the circuit breaker. So something's shorted. Something's rotten in Denmark. So, like I said, with the picture tube being shot, thought I'd try to have a little fun with it, but guess not, that's that. Alrighty, at least we got a good cheater cord, if nothing else, out of this thing. Alrighty, let me go see what I'm going to do. So, I unbolted the chassis and I actually loosened the, you see that frame going up to the yoke. I made sure that wasn't stuck and the chassis wouldn't pull back. I'm like, what's going on? So I said, you know, this is about where the end of my Sams are. And I did have the Sams for this set. And you have to take out all of the bolts around them that hold the mask to the cabinet. And this whole thing in one piece, tube and all, comes out of the front. So, I guess I'm about to yank it all out the front. But, how do you like that? Alrighty. Well, I started playing around to see I could find something shorted, what was causing a circuit break of the trip, and the transformer isn't shorted. I went around, the filter cans aren't shorted, they seem to be okay, and I said, you know, probably ain't the right way to do it, but kind of quick and dirty since we ain't keeping this thing anyhow. I just took put the set the meter on continuity. And I started testing all of these old caps, these bumblebees and orange drops and these pieces of garbage here. And I went across and this one right here, that cap right there, that bumblebee is testing, is showing shorted. And that goes between the cathode or the video output tube to ground. So, and it's definitely testing shorted. It's in parallel with that resistor next to it. Right to the left, the resistor seems okay. It's still measuring 15 ohms like it should, but you know, we're getting a short across there. So that thing is supposed to be a, I forgot already, that thing's supposed to be a 0.033. Well, I went and dug through my stash down the street, and I do have a 0.033. Couldn't remember whether it was a 0.33 or 0.33. So I grabbed something for both. So we have a, I think this is her here. Yep, we have a 0.033, 600 volts. That's a 200 volt cap, so that's plenty good enough. And I did put this, this is one of those old stock caps I've already put on the cap tester. And she's good, so we're going to clip her in there and see what happens. Alright, so there we got the cap in place. We got the bumblebee disconnected from the circuit. And we'll plug her in and see if that circuit breaker trips. So here we go. Here goes nothing. No circuit breaker tripping. Oh, with this halogen on, I can't see if there's any filaments lighting in the tubes. I wonder if I even have this thing on. Okay. Power switch is on. Maybe the circuit breaker ain't reset. Let's give that a shot. Nope. It's still tripping. Still tripping. Ooh. Well, anyhow. Well, I guess it was worth a shot, but I got no current meter. So if the circuit break is bad, I got no way to monitor the current to keep this thing from blowing up. Well, maybe we'll have some fun anyway. But it's time for me to go eat dinner, so I'll be back. Well, we played around with it a little more and Shango 66 just happened to telephone while I was fooling with it and tried a couple of things, and it looks like the transformer is shorted. It's still hot. We put the meter across the circuit breaker to try to measure the draw, and it went over scale. And yeah, you could hear it cooking. So this big old honking transformer with the heat sink fins on the side, this sucker's no good. So that's the end of this thing. Saving the chassis, and the rest will meet its maker this tomorrow morning. So that's it for the 16K33 Haratty from 1963.